When I was a kid, there were barely any high-rises in China.
But over the past decade, China has dwarfed the rest of the world in construction of skyscrapers. Now, half of the 20 tallest buildings in the world are on the Chinese mainland, and half of China's tallest are in the provinces and cities along the Yangtze River.
We're now at the top of the under-construction Wuhan Greenland Center. It stands 500 meters tall. For now, it will replace the Shanghai Tower to be China's tallest building next year when it reaches its full height of 636 meters. And that's the Yangtze River.
Yes, the area surrounding the super tall structure will be a new business district on the Yangtze River waterfront in Wuhan. Wuhan, population 10 million, is the largest city in the middle reaches of the river, and it's also a major player in the country's economy as a transportation hub, an industrial base, and home to numerous universities and high-tech firms.
Today, we're going to spend a night here in Wuhan and feel the growing vitality of the last known heartland of the world's second largest economy. For thousands of years, the Yangtze River has been important for the Chinese society and the economy. The world's third longest river runs through 9 Chinese provinces and 2 municipalities. The Yangtze River economic belt accounts for more than 40% of the national population and GDP.
This is the Yingwuzhou Yangtze River Bridge. It's one of the longest suspension bridges in the world.
That was the Wuhan Yangtze River Bridge, and it was the first permanent bridge to cross the Yangtze River. That bridge was built in 1950s. It was a major infrastructural project in the early years of the People's Republic.
Recent years, bridge building has begun to accelerate, not only in Wuhan, but also in many other cities along the Yangtze River.
So how many Yangtze River bridges are there in Wuhan?
Well, there are 9, and another 2 will be completed next year.
The biggest car buying boom in history is underway in China. The country has been the world's number one auto market for 9 consecutive years. About 29 million new vehicles were sold nationwide last year. Global and domestic automakers expect even more growth in this vast country.
Meanwhile, big cities along the Yangtze River are vying to build themselves into auto production centers. Wuhan has long been open to global big names. The city has more than 10 car factories.
This is a local venture of the French auto giant PSA Group. It's one of the earliest foreign car ventures in China. Last year, it sold 380,000 vehicles in the country. So what do you think about the Chinese market?
So what I think is that, in fact, the Chinese market is now growing at a more moderate pace. But it still remains a very important market for automotive. And by this point, I think it's very important for PSI to keep the volume and to increase the volume to keep the position of the market. Next point I would like to say, you know, we are now building some engine in China. And from the beginning of 2018, we have already delivered in Europe by rail 48,000 engines.
The Yangtze River has been crucial in linking the One Belt and One Road. In fact, Wuhan has become one of the best examples thanks to its central position and its rail, road, and waterway networks. Jiqing is such a happening street. Thanks to these hard-working late-night workers, the night of Wuhan is full of energy.
What's the city like in your eyes?
I worked here for a few months in 2011, the year marked the 100th anniversary of the 1911 revolution. that had ended the imperial rule in China. The city was where the first shots of the uprising were fired. But honestly, Wuhan captured my heart with its food, the hot dry noodles. You were born here. What's Wuhan like to you?
Well, Wuhan is a city on rivers. I remember the days when my father taught me to swim. And he said, living by the Yangtze River, you are not supposed to be afraid of water. You've got to be brave and swim across it one day like a conqueror.
Did you ever make it?
Oh no, I don't have the skills or the courage, though I know a lot of people do. And also we have built a new relationship with the river.
What's the new relationship?
The river nurtures us like a mother and we take care of her like her children. Well, it's getting close to midnight and some people have already started a new day's work. Let's go take a look.
Why not?
Right near the Yangtze River is one of the largest high-speed train maintenance centers in China. 9 years ago, the country's first bullet train, designed to travel up to 350 kilometers per hour, started its maiden trip here.
Now China has the world's longest high-speed rail network, with 1.7 billion trips delivered last year. 85% of the country's provinces and regions are served by high-speed rail, and Wuhan is right at the center of the national rail grid.
Trains here run a daily average of 3,000 kilometers. Some of them carry up to 2,000 passengers a day.
The examination is critical for a safe trip, and that's the job of the machinists here.
It's almost dawn. When the maintenance work is finished.
A new day has begun for the trains and the people along the Yangtze.